Hi, I'm Anka Cotwell, and I'm an Android developer advocate.
Hi, I'm Alex Danilo, and I'm a Chrome developer advocate.
Today, we want to talk to you about some new developer features that we've added in the WebView on Android. So, more specifically, Android 4.4, also known as KitKat, introduced an updated WebView, which is actually built off the Chromium WebView now. And that brings a whole range of new features for developers.
That's right, Anka. In fact, what we've built now into the WebView is all the functionality of Chrome. So what that means to you as a developer is that you have all the HTML5 capabilities that exist in Chrome shifted into the WebView so you can take advantage of modern HTML5 and all its APIs, which is kind of nice.
Absolutely. So let's have a look at a demo.
Well, before we should go into the demo, I just wanted to point out something. That one thing that's been really hard for me as a developer is actually debugging stuff in a WebView. Like, I mean, how do you debug normally when you're building Android applications?
I use Android Studio or Eclipse.
Right, like I used to as well. But you know, when I'm developing on the desktop, I use Chrome DevTools, which really makes my life simple. And now you can actually do it from the WebView. So why don't we just have a look at how we actually go about doing that? What I have here is we have like a little full screen game, and it's you hit the start button here, and what you have is like a ball that you can roll around. Okay, so it's a kind of a standard thing. But what I'd like to point out here is that we're actually using the motion in the device to control the ball. We couldn't do that before, could we, Anka?
No. So this is now the accelerometer, and the Chromium WebView is mapping that hardware accelerometer on your Android device straight through to the WebView itself. So this is a demo that Alex, you built, we're now, this app here is effectively, it's a web app. It's just a thin wrapper of an app that drops in a web view, and it's logged into your site, isn't it?
Exactly. And so the beauty of this is that now we have this web view, and in the old days, prior to KitKat, you'd be thinking, how do I debug this? It's really hard. But what I can do is I can come over here to Chrome, and I can just go over and have a look at Chrome Inspect. If I go and have a look at that, you'll suddenly see the devices that are connected to my laptop visible. And here we actually see we've got a Nexus 10 running this application at the moment. And you can see the actual web view itself. So for Android developers, you'd be familiar with this, com.alex.roller. So that's the namespace my app's been developed in. So all I have to do is click this Inspect link. And lo and behold, we have the full Chrome DevTools experience, identical to what happens on a desktop, but now it's actually talking to the device, and I can look at the DOM, I can breakpoint JavaScript, I can modify the DOM on the fly.
So let's. And this is not a special build of your app, right?
It works for
debug and release builds.
Exactly, that's the beauty of it. This is for any app that uses the Chrome WebView now, which is fantastic. So I can drill down, look in the DOM here, and of course, I can see the start button, but there's no game content. You can see hovering over it, it's actually changing what you can see on the screen. So if I actually tap the start, to start the game, you see all of a sudden all these new elements appear in the DOM. So this is a live DOM actually on the fly. And if you have a look at down here, the very bottom, which I have that highlighted, you can see the rotation and the transforms are changing on the fly. So as the ball is moving around, this is actually changing live. So this is just fantastic. Although Android, the holes that the ball falls into, they're a bit dark for me. What do you think?
Yeah, I mean, all of our UX research shows that you should use lighter colors, Alex.
I think you're right. So why don't we do that? Why don't we actually change the color that we're seeing? So if I go back up the top, since I actually wrote this, I know what to look at. But
there's I noticed that says SVG. That's also a newer feature of the Chromium WebView, right?
Exactly right.
SVG support.
That's right. Well, we brought in SVG support. I think it was Honeycomb was the first version that supported it, but now the WebView actually has it, and it has it, and it flies. So I've got these gradients here that are used for the holes. So if you have a look, here's this gradient that's black and gray. I might just decide that I'd prefer the holes to be blue, start as blue. So if you actually watch as I change that, all the holes suddenly change to blue. So we're actually modifying the live DOM, and this is like an incredible feature. So the ball itself, let's go down to the ball. Let me have a look. You'll notice we have a Chrome logo there on the ball, right? See, that's a Chrome logo spinning around, which is controlled by this image here. Now, I could actually just select it and delete it. And lo and behold, our ball has become a blue ball because we've taken away that image. And this is like really bad because now we can't tell the ball from the holes. So we can actually change the color of that circle that is the ball, and it becomes red. And we can again see what it looks like. So there you have it. We have actual live editing on the fly of our web app without any code changes, and you can do this from your desktop, from your laptop, on the fly. I mean, it's just an awesome new feature in KitKat.
And we should also add that when we connected with Chrome, we didn't need ADB or the developer tools installed. It's all built into Chrome now, and you can connect directly. It just shows up.
That's exactly right. Pro tip for all the developers out there, turn on hardware acceleration, because that will make your apps fly with the new view. So hardware acceleration, HTML5 features. I love KitKat. It's fantastic.
Thank you.